How's it going? My name is John. I wanted to make a quick video to help people buy a Canon camera. Now this is for people who have zoned it down to the T series, the T2i, all the way up to the T5i. They can't choose which one of those to get, or the 60D. So if you're trying to get one of those, because they're all very similar, similarly priced, right there. So it's kind of a difficult choice of all these cameras, little features, little differences. So I've watched every review because it's my first big purchase into a camera, and I bought the 60D, spoiler alert, but I did a lot of research and I watched a lot of reviews, and I'm going to smash them all because a lot of reviews go, you know, what's better, the T2i to the T3i, then the T4i to the 60D, blah, blah, blah. So I'm going to smash them all together. If you're trying to buy a camera, I'm going to help you choose in that little series. Also, the 7D, I would honestly disclude. It's the least appealing option, because it's got the same sensor as all the cameras I just mentioned, but it for some reason is, you know, noticeably more expensive than all those ones. So if you're a really dedicated photographer, it's got a few extra features that you might like, but for me it's the most pointless option. And then really quickly, the Canon 5D Mark II and Mark III, you know, if you're gonna buy one of those, you probably already know what you're doing. So I'm gonna discredit those a little bit by saying they're very similar. Like I've shot with my friend on the Mark III, and I watched reviews, and basically even those, you know, images and videos, they look so similar to what you're getting on the T series or the 60D. I mean, of course that's on a full frame sensor, so, you know, in low light situations, if you zoom in, definitely less noisy than the cameras I'm speaking of. But other than that, you know, if it's well lit and you know what you're doing about video and photography, they're gonna look very similar, pictures and video alike. You know, it's those cameras are for, you know, really serious photographers, maybe doing fast sports, and in low light, it definitely is way better. But the ones I'm talking about, I wanna do a quick review and help you choose. All right, so the features are very similar. And for me, I'll tell you why I end up choosing the 60D, but first I'll go through like the subtle differences. So the T2i, the only reason I knocked that off the list is because it doesn't have the swivel screen. I love the swivel screen for like low shots, high shots. I really like that. So every camera has the 9-point focus system. The first two, the T2i and the T3i, are the only ones who have one cross-type autofocus point. The rest, the T4i, 5i, 60D, all have all 9 points cross, and it's just a slightly better focusing system. Frames per second. The only difference is the T2i and the T3i are at like 3.5, I think it is, frames per second, whereas the T4i and the 5i and the 60D, they're all faster frames per second at 5 frames per second. So you'll get, you know, faster shots with the ones I mentioned, as opposed to the T2i and the T3i, it's more. And unless you're, again, like into fast sports photography and it's very important to get fast shots really quick, because I mean the T2i and the T3i, they're still fast. But if you're doing, you know, like a really fast sport like NASCAR or something, and you need that fast, you know, shooting birds, I don't know. But if it's really not that important, unless you're a really dedicated photographer to, you know, sports or what have you. The Canon 60D is the only camera who has a 1/8000th of a second shutter speed. All the other ones only go up to 4000. And that's not a huge deal if you're really into photography, again, and you shoot sport, really, really fast sports or birds or something. That shutter speed can help capture motion a little bit, but really, you don't usually go over 4,000. It's not a big deal. The T4i and the T5i have one stop higher ISO, so it doesn't go to 6,400. It goes all the way to 12,800. And again, that's not that big of a deal, because if you're going over 6,400, it's going to get pretty noisy, and you know, you want to try to avoid that. If you're trying to shoot and you have to go all the way up to that 12,800, you're going to want to change the lighting or get more lights, because up there, you know, you're not going to get professional quality images or video. It's going to be pretty noisy. So again, similar to the shutter speed, that's not very important either. All right, so let's get down to why I bought the 60D and why you might buy a certain camera. Okay, because again, they all are on the same sensor, crop sensor, and you're gonna get you're gonna get the same image and video quality. So then why buy which camera? One reason is, you know, options, you know, menu options, and they all have very, very similar menu options. like maybe one difference that I noticed, the 60D has the in-camera leveler as an extra option. And besides that, if there are any differences, they're not important. So why else? Well, that would be functionality, you know? This is where it comes down to it pretty much. That screen, you know, the T2i is the only one who doesn't have the swivel screen. And that was what I wanted. I wanted that because it helps very much in images and video especially, when you can spin the screen up and, you know, you're down low or you're up high and you spin the screen. And it just saves a lot of time, and it's definitely worth paying, you know, the $100 just for that swivel screen. So then I landed on the T3i and the 60D, because one thing I definitely have to mention, obviously, is T4i, T5i, touchscreen. And the reason I didn't discredit it, but the reason I said that's not important to me is because I'm a fairly new photographer. You know, like, I know what I'm doing, and I've taken many pictures, but this is my first big DSLR buy. And the touchscreen, it was appealing, but I didn't want it because I want to do everything in camera. It's a cool new feature, brand new, you know, it's kind of imitating smartphones, and it makes things definitely a little faster. Wow, I can touch it real fast. But for me, I want to learn how to do everything in camera really proficiently and effectively before I ever go into the touchscreen area, because right now, who knows, it's kind of a new technology for DSLRs, and it might just kind of be a fad. Or, you know, it might even pick up in some of the new higher-end cameras that are like $4,000, like the Mark III. Maybe the Mark IV might have touchscreen, and maybe it picks up, and maybe that's the new thing. But even if it is, to me, it's not a big deal, because I want to learn how to do everything in camera. And so if you really love that touchscreen, you know, it's basically just like an iPhone. You can slide photos, you can touch it, you know, it's kind of quicker. But it might save you a little bit of time. To me, it wasn't a big deal. Some people love it, but I want to learn to do everything in camera. So that made me forget about the T4i and the T5i, because it was the only reason I was looking at them was for that touchscreen. So none of that. So I landed on the T3i and the 60D. And what it came down to is a couple of things. One was the feel. The 60D is slightly bigger, and I have pretty big hands, and I like that. I also really, okay, so this the I really like the top LED screen on the 60D. The T3i doesn't have that. None of the T-Series does. It's got a top LED screen, so you don't have to look in the camera. It's, to me, a little, it's just a time saver when I'm doing video and pictures. I love looking at that top. I'm used to looking at one on my previous camera, and I like that a lot. And the other thing that I really, really like is the turnstile with the thumb. So I can change, you know, the shutter speed on top and the aperture with my thumb with the little turnstile. And the T-Series doesn't have that, it's just got the arrows. The 60D has the turnstile and arrows. And so that was pretty much the big reason. One more thing I just wanted to mention, sorry I just had to do this manually, is that the 60D can only record video for, it's I think 12 minutes, and then it will stop. That's as long as you record video for. It has to do with overheating or something. Whereas in the T-Series, you can record for 30 minutes. Now that's only really a big deal if, you know, you're recording like maybe a kid's soccer game or something, you just wanted to keep going for, you know, at least 30 minutes. And otherwise, like if you're filming movies, usually, you know, it's the clips aren't more than a couple minutes, so it doesn't really matter, but that's one thing worth mentioning. Besides that, the buttons on the 60D, they're not as clicky as the T-Series. Like in a T-Series, you kind of know you're touching a button. It's like click. But in the 60D, it's like it kind of smushes, and it doesn't bug me that much. But that might be something if you're really into clicky buttons. The 60D buttons are like, you touch them, but you don't really know you touched it, except they're really sensitive and it works. But you know, if you like a clicky button, that's one other thing. And then the big other thing was the battery. I mean, this is big for me. It might be a stupid point, but the battery in the 60D is almost three times longer lasting than all the T-Series. It uses an LPE6 battery, just like the 70, whereas all the T-Series uses an LPE8, and I've seen different stats, but basically I've seen the LPE8, the T-Series battery, lasts about 500 shots, while the LPE6 lasts for about 1500 to 1600 shots, so it's a lot longer lasting battery. One more thing that is mentionable is on the top, when you're turning the modes, the 60D is the only one who has this, and I don't like it that much. It's not a deal breaker for me, it might be for you. you need to touch a little button in the middle to rotate it. Like it's a safety lock, as if, you know, it's like saying you don't want to bump it into a different mode. So you have to touch this button in the middle to change it. All the other ones, you can spin it all, you can just spin it without locking. And in the T4i and the T5i, you can spin it all the way around and it doesn't stop at all. Or in the T2 and the T3, it's got like an end point, you turn it around. But the 60D is the only one who has this little touch, little button that you have to hold in to spin it. And it's just like, it just takes a second extra to do it. It's kind of annoying, but it's not like, for my fingers, I got good dexterity, so I'll like push it in and I'll turn it real fast. It doesn't change anything really for me. It's just kind of stupid. It's just kind of unnecessary. So it might be something to consider for you, so I just want to mention it. Okay, so that's basically it, except, of course, prices. You know, they change, so I'm not going to necessarily tell you what it is, but, you know, now you know enough information to say if it's $100 more to get from upgrade to the T2i to the 3-3i, well, you know, like, it's for the swivel screen or what have you. So, I'm not going to talk too much about prices, because they're all very similar. You know, the T3i is, like, $200 cheaper than the T5i. So, if you love that touch screen, that'd be one of the only reasons to upgrade for me. The 60D is maybe like $100 more than the T3i, which was what I was choosing between, and I ended up choosing again on the top LED screen, the bigger feel, and the turnstile. So, you know, it's kind of up to you. So I'm going to show you after... Oh, saw a bird! I'm going to show you a bunch of... just a few clips that I'm going to take with my Canon 60D. And you can just see, I'm going to show you just some video footage, so you can say, oh yeah, this has got great footage. You can compare it to other video clips or whatever. I'm only going to do it on the 60D, because again, if I did it on the T-Series, or I could do them on each camera I talked about, and they look exactly the same. So I'm just going to do a quick, you know, for fun, you can watch these videos that follow, or not. You can just turn it off. Alright, great, thanks a lot. See you guys later.
Brother, there's an endless road to rediscover. Hey, sister, know the water's sweet, but blood is thicker. Oh, if the sky comes falling down for you, there's nothing in this world I wouldn't do. What if I lose it all? Oh, sister, I will help you out.